Hello, welcome back to Let's Talk Song. Today, special edition, we're mixing it up. We're going to look at a song that I produced, a song by Rafael Cano. You know Rafael, he's first of all my cohort, co-host in my songwriting course that's coming out later. And he's a brilliant songwriter, but he also got better and better and better. He hears where he wants to go, but it doesn't mean that early on he knew about modal interchange and secondary dominance and sub-fives and all that bullshit. He might have used it without really knowing what's going on, which just means it's harder to reproduce it when you want to get that sound again. So throughout the years, I think I've been working with him now since 2008 or something like this. So we've known each other for quite a while. And when I got to know him, he was 20 or something like this, like fucking young. So this is a song he wrote a few years ago, and it was supposed to be on the Campaign Like Clockwork album. We don't know if it's going to go on there. You know it as the NAMM song. NAMM, 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 NAMM. Different world. Let's bring up the chords. Actually, no. I could, but I have a full video on it. Let's watch that video, enjoy the song, and then we're going to take it apart, and I'm going to show you why and how Rafa does what he does. And we've looked at songs that have a problem here or there. Now, not saying that this song didn't have any problems, but obviously, since Rafa and I, we worked on it, he brought it to me, and I did what I do in these videos. According to what I think, the problems are gone. Except maybe a little bit long on the solo, but it's also something I use for guitar videos. So long solo is a good idea. So let's look at it. Here's Different World.
This is a different world.
a good song. Why? Well, good themes, easy themes. I'm going to take the Halabitsa QD. Halabitsa guitars right here. People have asked, what guitar is that? It's a Halabitsa from Slovakia. There will be a video on it. What a simple theme. Why? Well, we got four notes, right? And then we repeat it. What is that? Well, we're playing a C. Playing chord notes, except that second there. I mean, C, C, C with that melody, and then again. Then the same thing again, but this time with an F, which makes that E a major 7, so it brings in a little bit of something cool. That's a 5 building up. Simple. Going back to the 1. That very narrow range theme works. How does that look here? Starting on the 1. So definitely super simple. It actually to me sounds like Löwenzahn. Is it Löwenzahn? I think so. There's a German kids show. It's a kids melody. It's a very, very, very simple melody, but it just gets you in the groove. It gets you going. It's fun. So we're going to look at the chords and how simple they are, with two exceptions where we did, or he did, I don't know who suggested it actually, twisted it a bit. Then actually on how to take chords into a riff, how to take a chord progression and make a riff out of it, which Rafa doesn't know. Rafa deals in I play chords, okay? A riff is a theme you do with chords. A lick, to me, is single notes. That's a lick, but that's a riff, at least in my understanding of guitar. And this is a great concept, a great example of taking chords and making them more interesting. Okay, so here's the lead sheet. Let's look at intro. Ultra freaking simple, right? C C C C C C C C C C C C C C C C C C C C C C F F F F A G A G. Okay, very, very, very simple. And we're clearly in C major. It's a 1. It's a 4. It's a 6 minor. It's a 5. So we're stable, 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 floaty. Back to stable. Build up, going back home, and the verse is the same. So once the verse hits, you're already in the mood. You know, Bagheera, stop with the couch. Cat clawing on the couch. You're already in the mood for the song. You already know where it's going. Before we go into the riff, let's look at the chord. And then we got the pre-chorus. So instead of going to the one, we're going back to the four. Building up. Imagine it's just a stop. Sometimes a stop is a great idea, okay? I mean, how much easier could it be than a four and a five for the pre-chorus? Okay, this is home. And you're doing... Can't get freaking simpler than that. Imagine a life without fear. Imagine a... That's the kicker. Now, last week we looked at Michael Koenig and he just went into three different, if the first one even was a key, three different keys. Now, not necessary. Here, we have two little tricks up our sleeve and that's all that's happening. It's in C, very clearly in C. There's one chord in the chorus and it's not the first chord. It's the second chord is in E major. It definitely does not fit into C major. But look at what's coming next. It's A minor. So that E is a secondary dominant. That E is the five of what's coming after. So we got a one, and then a one, and then a five of six, a five of six, to the six. Okay? That's the trick. It's so cool. That's how I'm playing it. But imagine a life without fear. Imagine a world. I think he's actually singing that G sharp. Life. Yeah, he's actually, that's the melody note. Imagine a life without, I don't know, fear. We can look at the lyrics. La da 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 da. That's the kicker. It's so unique. And he actually takes the out of key note, the one out of key note that we need, and puts it in the melody. Da 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 da. Imagine a life. Goes to the five of the A minor. Life without sorrow, my dear. We're back to the four. So hypothetically, technically, this is very simple. It's a one, then something else, and then it's six, four, five. Six, four, five. That's the Andalusian cadence right there. That goes back to the A minor, but we're not doing it there, we're doing it before it, okay? Six, five, four, six, four, five, six, five, four. What did I say? And then we do it again. And then that's the second cool thing that's happening there. It's the F minor, which is why it's red, to really stand out. Remember, we talked about it quite a bit. On the four, you can do four major and then four minor. It's preferred to do the major to the minor. Sometimes you can jump to four minor directly. Rafa's doing that in his song today. What a beautiful song. We should look at that one day. It's fucking amazing. But here we're doing the traditional four major to four minor. And then back to... We're actually stopping on it. So it's... Imagine a world without sorrow, my dear. Very traditional. So we've got two, really only two out of key moments. Secondary dominant on the E, which is a five of six. It's the five that will prepare that the six is coming. and the four to the four minor. The rest of the song is drastically simple, 1, 4, 5 and six minor. Look at other chords, you will not find them. It's 1, 4, 5, 6 minor. That is it. It's four chords and two with a special kind of a thing. Everything else, not really relevant. We got, let's look at it. Intro, verse, and we got an intro. The verse is the same as the intro. We got the pre-chorus with the 4 and a 5. We got the chorus. We just talked about that. Then back to the intro half. Then again, verse, pre-chorus, chorus, the same section again, you know, stick with what you know. And then the bridge, which is really the verse, only that on that F, we're not doing A minor G. It's like, it's just not doing the A minor G, which is kind of a nice little hanging there. And then the solo is a variation of it. So we're starting on. Imagine a. Okay. Now, if we're looking at the last chorus, it is the same thing, but arranging kicks in. Is this songwriting or is it arranging? So we got C, C, E, E, A minor, G, F. C, C, E, E, A minor, G, F, F minor. But what's with all the crap there? Well, I will put the chabitza away. Arranging kicks in and is brilliant. I love it. I love arranging. So if we look at it, it's a C, C with E in the bass. So all of a sudden the E is already the bass and then just the chord on top changes. So we're doing a bass change, top change, bass change. So we're doing this, if you know what I mean. It's just, let's make the last chorus sound more interesting. And all that's happening is the bass is doing other chord tones. And also the guitars, you got to be careful, are probably playing a register higher. They're playing an octave higher, not to get muddled with the bass. So the arrangement will be different in the guitar voicings. So here's what's happening. Bass movement, C, E, E, G sharp. We're not doing the flat 9 there. We should if we did it, but we're not doing it. So, oh, I'm doing, ah. And then the A minor. And then we're going to the G, but the bass is going up. Then the C, but this, no, then the F, but with the C in the bass. Which makes it even more floaty. You know you're going somewhere else. Let's do this whole thing again. Okay. Repetition. Not the same thing, because that would be boring. C. Find a place that you know. C with a C in the bass. C with a G in the bass. Cool. Now again, the E with the G sharp immediately. E with a B. A minor with the C. G with a B. F with an A. So you're doing playing thirds down. How cool is that, huh? And then the, so I got the second half again. So we're really doing... Is that what's happening? No, from the B to the C. Wait. Ah, yeah. That sounds so cool. Now I'm doing the song. Let's do the whole chorus. It is a different world. So we did not change a thing other than bass movement. You didn't see that anywhere else in the song. Why? Well, that leaves the last chorus to be this big reharmonization. But nobody else plays anything different other than the bass. And really, it's just chord tones. It's 1/1/3, 5/6. 5/6/3, 6. I mean, and so on and so on. So, very simple, but what we're doing is playing with the simplicity. We're playing with the 1, 4, 5, 6 minor, and the secondary dominant. And all we're doing is, really, if you count, that's 5 chords, that's it. But we're doing something different with the bass movement. Now, if we look back at the riff, what did I do with the riff? So technically, we've got this. And I said to Rafa, well, we need to do a riff. And then I explained to him what a riff is. I really had to. So I said, well, why don't we do in the guitar, not the bass. The bass is good. Already in the intro and the verse, make it part of the part that... C over E. So the guitar riff is... That's a typical... You know, that's the Hendrix thing. So it's a C right here. Those three. With an E in the bass. So you got this chord, and you take your ring finger there, slide it up on the third, and bar this bit. Okay, so that's really all it is. I'm doing these hammer-ons. I'm hammering on the 2 and the 6. I'm actually doing a sus 2, I think. And then I'm going up to the F right here. I'm not going to this F. I'm actually doing voice leading. I'm going as little movement as possible. That F. Then F9. So you got that in the melody. And again. You don't always hit that. It's difficult. And then A minor, but I'm not playing the root. And G. I'm not doing anything there, but I'm not playing the root because it's coming from here. From here. It's nicer to go E. So that's, of course, what the bass is doing. The bass is doing the root. The whole thing all that it is exactly those chords, but we added some movement within. Instead of the C in the bass the whole time, we're doing C and then E in the bass. A little bit of movement. F. A little bit of movement on top. Really nothing happening. Okay? And that actually is also what's happening in the verse. Just... just a little bit more muted. Now the chorus, I'm doing this. Doing a big E. Everything's anticipated, by the way. Doing a big E power chord. What am I doing? I'm doing the same thing I did on the C. See? With the 2 to the major 3, bar the rest of the chord. And then I walk it back. And I know that that'll never be in the way. Because it's just chord tones. And that means it's a riff that I can play while he's singing. Imagine. Then A minor. So everything's anticipated, which is kind of difficult, except for the F. F minor. So what did I do here? A little bit of a riff element, which means I'm just walking the bass notes a bit. In the key of C, down to the A. Anticipate. And then up. So, A down. G up. That's 2 measures, so I'm strumming. And on the last measure, I'm playing a full F major 7-9 arpeggio, which just means I'm doing F, F, G, A, then the 5, major 7, and that is followed by the anticipated C again. It's difficult. So I'm doing this. And then I'm really doing the F minor. And the whole band is doing. It is a different world. And so on and so on. So really, I did riffage that doesn't get in the way and that doesn't destroy anything. It's actually outlining the chords. But there's movement. It's not just... so, let's see. We can show this on piano. A minor. No idea how to do that. I'm actually doing F sharp there. I gotta get better at piano again. But now it's got a nice one, so you haven't seen it. Can I show you? Where? Here, there. I bought a Piano 5 by Nord, so that I can actually have something that I just turn on, freaking go and play. It's got, you know, kick-ass sounds and, you know, whirlies. Just different writing on a piano than writing on guitar. You write differently, not better, not worse, but you, I think harmonically you're cleverer, and especially your bass movement's different. But there's going to be a whole lesson in our songwriting course on writing on piano. What's it good for? What's it not good for? Can you see how I'm trying to push you on that course? Well, it makes sense because it's a good course. So that is the harmonic structure and how we took the chords into a riff. Let's look at lyrics. Okay, I have no idea. I haven't analyzed that. I just hear Rafa singing it and it makes sense to me. So, farewell, my lover. Okay. I don't think he's rhyming. I was going to say, I don't think he's rhyming that with anything, but that's not correct. I think it's time for us to start. To part. I'm already rhyming it. I think it's time for us to part. That's nice. Farewell, my lover. I think it's time for us to part. See how he's not using dumbed down lingo? Farewell. It's time for us to part. It's nice. It's prose. I guess I should have seen this from the start. So, three different length of lines, which is nice, but now that means he's got to fucking repeat that every time, so it's going to be exponentially more difficult to actually write the rest of the song. Farewell, my lover, I think it's time for us to part. Guess I should have seen this from the start. He will have to have those lines three more times because there's two verses and that's only half a verse. Goodbye, my brother. There he rhymes it. So it's an A, B, B, A, C, C. See? He's doing, that's rhyme A, which comes back here. This is rhyme B, part and start. And he's got friend and end. So it's an A, B, B, A, C, C. Very, very cool and clever. He's aware of it. Okay? And he will absolutely... I see what he's doing in verse 2. So, goodbye, my brother. He is to you my only friend. Think it's time for us to part. Exactly the same melodic rhythm there. That is how you do it. Okay, this is what I want you guys to understand and pay attention to. And then send me that stuff where you're doing that. If only for tonight, let's pretend that the start, that's the start. What is he doing there? He's actually taking that line into the bridge. So it's, goodbye, my brother. Here's to you, my only friend. Only for tonight, let's pretend that's the start, not the end. Prosody. Meaning of the word being reflected in the arrangement of the music. Only for tonight, let's pretend that's the start, not the... Let's pretend that's the start. And he's singing that, I've never noticed. Oh, the fucking Rafa. He's singing that at the start of a new section. So he's starting the new section by saying, let's pretend it's the start. Goodbye, my brother. Here's to you, my only friend, all on the sea. Really? Wait. Goodbye, my brother. Here's to you, my only friend. Nothing on the F. If only for tonight, let's pretend that's the start, not the end. Wow. So let's see where he starts the lines. Farewell, one, two, fair on the three. One, two, farewell, my brother. Think it's farewell, my lover. One, two, think it's on the three. Time for us to part. Three, four, one, two. I guess I... Okay, that is before the chord. Cause it should have seen it from the start. But so you're starting on the three most of the time. But then the chorus, contrast, because he's actually taking imagine, that's a pickup. And now if you just look at the lyrics, imagine, 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 imagine. It's just painting a picture. He's saying, imagine, imagine a life without fear. Beautiful. Imagine a life. Imagine your eyes without tears. Oh, I have no idea what he was singing there. Imagine your eyes without tears. Eyes without tears. Imagine a world without sorrow, my dear. So it's an AAA, BBB, CC. This is why this guy's good and why he's teaching you how to do songwriting. If you so choose to buy the song. Imagine a life without fear. Imagine your eyes without tears. Imagine a world without sorrow, my dear. Imagine a place without time. Mistakes that we've made left behind. Damn, this is good. Mistakes that we made left behind. One look at your face, and he's actually going up there. One look at your face, and he's actually face. He's singing this really high, and most of the time doesn't hit it. One look at your face, and I know you don't mind. So time behind mind. Fierce tears, dear. Time behind mind. A-A-A-B-B-B, but hey, girl, this is a different world. This is a different world. Okay, girl, world. Let me do it again in really bad. I mean, I'm not a singer, but this is what you have to do. You have to get over yourself when you're working with people, when you're trying to teach, when you're working with someone on a song. You have to sing, even though it sounds like complete crap, okay? That's what he's doing. And then imagine your eyes. So he's doing on the G. And then that's so cool. Imagine a life without fears. Imagine your eyes without tears. Imagine a world without sorrow, my dear. Oops. Imagine a place without time. Mistakes that we made left behind. One look at your face and I know you don't mind. Hey girl, this is a different world. If you can take the song, even though there's a riff and all that shit, play it on piano just for simple chords and it's still the song, then you know you got something. Look at verse 2. Farewell, my lover. He's starting it with the same line. You probably didn't have one. And revisiting your power position, which is line one, verse one, is a power position. Well, it's not a bad thing if you ran out of ideas. If it was good there, it might be good again, as long as you then spin it off. And, okay. Farewell, my lover. Let the final curtain fall. Nice. We let the final curtain fall. I guess it is time. Let the final curtain fall. That's the F. Guess it's not the real thing. Everything okay, Bruno? You good? He spit up something. Guess it's not the real thing after all. I guess it's not the real thing after all. We know what the song is about. I mean, I never knew because I never paid attention to the lyrics until now. But now we know this song is a breakup song. Okay? I mean, it clearly is. See, can I make this bigger? It's brilliant. Again. Farewell, my lover. We let the final curtain fall. I guess it's not the real thing after all. So long, I'm leaving. It's one of my favorite lines ever. So long. And thanks for all the fish. I know why he didn't rhyme lover again, because he was trying to get the Douglas Adams line in there. So long and thanks for all the fish. I will absolutely forgive him for not doing the same rhyme scheme again, because it's fucking brilliant. So every time I hear this and we played it live, I have this smile on my face, because it's just like getting this line in there. It shows that Rafa and I are kin, as you, if you want that. So long, I'm leaving. And thanks a lot for all the fish. He's singing that. He's singing a major seven. Fish. He's not singing fish. For all the fish. Fish. He's not singing the sea. Fish. He's changing it up a bit. And so long I'm leaving. And thanks a lot for all the fish. So beautiful. If only with a magical swish, you could grant my last wish. So again, that's going into, it's verse and bridge morphed together. Friend, pretend. Oh, there's an inline rhyme that we missed up here. Friend and pretend. So we needed to do the same thing here. And I actually think at that point, I helped him write this. I think the magical swish is from me. I can't remember, but I think so. So long I'm leaving. Thanks a lot for all the fish. If only with a magical swish, you could grant, my last wish. Imagine a life without fish. And that's all there is. And then there's the, which is the bridge, but there's no lyrics. I love the Hitchhiker's reference, which starves us of one rhyme, but I can live without it. The chorus is beautiful. Imagine. And then breaks up with mistakes that we've made left behind. AAABBBCC, beautiful rhyme. You can see all the things that we've discussed in the previous weeks. Every time on a Sunday, let's talk song. Rafa has made them. I have made them, okay? For years, we've made these mistakes, and we still will make these mistakes if we're not careful. But now we know what to pay attention to. We now use pattern recognition. Oh, wait, we've got an AABB here, so we should probably do AABB in the second verse. What did we do in the first block of verse one? Oh, it's XAXA. Okay, so let's do XAXA again, so that there is a pattern. I'm sorry to say, but good songs are about patterns, rhythmical patterns, chord patterns that repeat, get cleverly rearranged with bass notes, rhyming patterns, phrase patterns. I'm leaving. Goodbye, my brother. So get the second lines. Think it's time for us to part. Here's to you, my only friend. We let the final curtain fall, and thanks a lot for all the fish. It's literally the same metric rhythm. If you recognize the patterns in your song, and then with new lyrics, which is the trick, change it up. Bam. If you recognize the rhythmical patterns, let them appear everywhere. Don't throw in a million different rhythms. If you recognize the chord patterns, repeat them, cleverly arrange them. That's what makes a great song. And you can disagree with me. That's fine. Come back next Sunday and disagree with me again. I'll see you there. Thanks, Rafa, for an amazing song and your friendship. And you guys for hanging out with me on Sundays for Let's Talk Song. Animals at the End.
what lies within. I'm like a snake in water.